I do think the amazing thing for women, though, is that, and I don't, I assume this happens for all women, is that it doesn't matter who you meet or where you are. I was introduced to a woman who was an extraordinary economist, and her whole resume, I mean, before I even met her, I said, I'm not meeting her. Okay, I'm just not meeting her. Her name is Dambisa Moyo. I mean, just Google her. It's incredible. And within 10 seconds, we were talking about our clothes. I mean, if there is a leveler with women, or there is an intimacy I find with women, there is a willingness to connect that I think we probably don't applaud or exploit enough.
Well, it's time to exploit it enough, ladies. We're actually doing something at Tribeca this year, which will be the first Time's Up Day. We're working with the group. We're going to launch New York Time's Up, and we're doing a whole day, which is not about just the entertainment business by any stretch. It's about, we have speakers from financial services, from farm workers, from legal aid, to, you know, trying to span every business, because the issue that's going on in our country, or let's now internationally, there will be Time's Up international, but just in terms of women's rights and pay parity, so that somebody doesn't say when you're going into that to buy a car, where is your husband? Or I'm actually curious, Brooke, how many women actually buy jewelry?
That's changed so dramatically in the last 5 years that 95% of our sales are self-purchased by women. And our average sale is $7,000. So that's a sea change. And I watched that happen, and I watched it happen because I was there so long and so long involved with my father. But there were always women, there was a level, and after that level, women wouldn't shop without their husband. And now it's just a complete afterthought that their husband is involved at all. And our online business is all men. That's who's buying online.